PDR coming at you here with a very nice car. It's a BMW 2017 BMW 335D, so it's a diesel, and it's a wagon. It's a pretty nice rare car, and if you see what we've got here, we've got a pretty big, I'd say 3.5 inch crease that is slightly diagonal and right close to the edge. The one thing that BMW does do is, well, they have this long flange that comes out, and it's a double skin, so that almost covers the whole dent. That flange goes out to here, so yeah, it covers the whole dent. But if you see, they have factory holes that are these little, I just took out that little plastic plug right there, and I can actually access that dent through there. So I could use my J-hook, come in through here, come up and around, and try to get to it that way. First things first, though, we're just gonna close the door and stick some glue tabs on it. Get the majority of that metal moved, and I think I'm gonna go with a nice long crease tab that's I don't know if this is the Titan. Pre-clean it a little bit. Make sure it's a nice, flush, even tab. Got the little bit of music going. And then we grab the Scorpion heat gun with some black plague glue. Switch my head around. And at this point's when I say, I sure do appreciate everybody clicking on this video. I really do. Hopefully the sound's okay. Using the same mic as last video. I'm waiting a couple of seconds before I stick this on. And yeah, I kind of want to set it right in the middle like that. And I'm going to pretty much pull it pretty darn quick. Let me grab my both things, my lifter and my sledgehammer, just because I never know which one I'm going to want. The lifter, this thing does have a little edge that I don't want to push down on the feet. But let's just see. Let's see here. Nah, it wasn't. The tab wasn't cleaned properly. So now, I know that didn't pull anything. So now let's give it a nice pull. Get some new bead of glue on there. That was about 4 pumps. And then drop it right on in and give it a nice push, because I want it to kind of ooze out of the sides of the tabs and pull evenly. Well, let's see how we're looking on that. I do notice that we have a little tiny dent right here, guys. A little tiny baby dent right there that we'll have to tackle also. Of course, we'll do that one for free and just throw that in. And I think we're looking good right about now. I'm gonna give it the slide hammer. Moved some metal, not a lot, but a little, and a little isopropyl on it, and some patience. Let's see what we moved. It's looking like it moved a little bit, and now I know I can always get into there with my tool, but I'm going to take some smaller tabs and move a little bit more metal out. I think right about there. Yeah, I could have tapped some areas down, which I might want to grab my hammer and tapper right here. It has a brand new red cap on it, and I might want to bring some of these little brows that are pinching in. Go from the top on this one. And hopefully that moved some metal. Let's see what we got there. Now this does have a little tiniest of paint scratches in it. Wow, that moved some metal there, guys. Before I do any more pulling, I'm gonna get right back on the tapper and bring down this ridged area right here. So take some time, guys. This dent I have scheduled for about 2 hours worth of work. It's not a quick one by any means, but I don't know if we will keep you in for the whole thing through speediness or just take some separate little clips. But basically, I'm gonna do as much as I can with the glue and then get in there behind it if I can. I haven't even checked access actually with my tool. I just saw that little hole, and I know that sometimes I can get up to half of this dent with my J hook. So yeah, I'm up in the weird little tight area up top. So if you're new to the channel, definitely hit that subscribe button. We sure love to see the community grow, and we appreciate everybody that clicks on this video, and feel free to leave a positive comment down below. This is really kind of a sharp one. It was not super severe, but once we got some of that metal moved, it sharpened it up. So I definitely have to bring it back into kind of a little bit more of a dent before I make any more pulls, because I don't want it to go sideways on me. But lots of tapping and lots of pulling to be done on this one. So what we'll probably do is just do some other little clips, and we'll come back and show you a little bit more progress in just a bit. I was using my tool from inside there a lot. I got it down to a little tiny bit. Now I think I'm just gonna use the glue puller for one more tad here. I wanna make sure that is a flat surface also. There we go. Excuse the advertisements. And it's gonna need some more tapping. You guys will hear that this is real solid right here where it goes up against the brace. Might always be a little high line there. The stent is not gonna be 100% perfect, but we're gonna get it to that really good 95% mark where it will be tough to see. Not really talking too much, guys. I've been on this for about an hour and a half in between customer phone calls. Just kind of trying to get some of this last little bit out. Ended up coming in behind it for a lot of it. Where it's gonna start coming out looking nice. Let me turn on the heater, get it nice and warm. And I've been coming in through the grommet and using my J hook, getting up in there like that. Sneak in here, come right up. And I'm at the very bottom now. Kind of a very strange angle too, because I've got the J hook going up and then back inside of this little flanged double skinned area. So if it gets too wedged back in there, it's kind of dicey. up through the middle of that crease line. Just trying to take it slow. Feel the heat on it. The high level of difficulty dent, guys. This one is something that I wouldn't be able to do in my first 5 years of doing paintless dent repair. At least to the level I'm getting it at right now. So we're just taking our time, making some real slow pushes. Obviously have the heater on it. And it was a pretty sharp little crease, so our whole goal is to get it out without cracking any paint or making any funky push marks. And I think we're getting there so far, other than this little crease in the center, which I'm going to basically have to tap down and bring back into a dent and then retake out. It's got a diagonal angle to it, and it's kind of a strange one. Turn that off for a little bit. Sounds like there's some kids playing in the background. And break some of this stuff down. Right there is where it's touching the brace on the inside. So we're just gonna keep on working on this thing. Give it a couple more minutes, I think, maybe more like 25 or 30. And we'll come back to you in the end here and show you our final result in just a bit. Okay, guys, here's what we ended up with. It's not perfect. It has a little wave to it. It has a little brow to it left over. But I think we got what we said we were going to do, which is get it out to that 90 to 95% mark. It was a real toughie. It had a lot of sharpness in it. And I think it came out looking real nice. So if you guys like what you see, hit us up with a like. And other than that, I'll just say the thing. This has been PDR and I'm out. Peace.
Are you kidding me? I couldn't pick it up on the camera. That's how much it was gone.
I know, but it's not. It's a tough
but, I mean, holy cow. You did awesome. Well, I just got a couple drinks and a hot chicken for dinner because you said you were hungry. Well, couldn't find some lemonade, so I ran to Safeway.
Well, then Safeway has them too.
I didn't see that section. I haven't bought cigarettes for a long, long time. I didn't see that section. I got. No, but we can stop on the way. God, you damn fiend. God.